Hello and welcome, I'm Arumba, thank you for joining me. Let's play some more Khan of Khans in Crusader Kings 2. So, we're not able to create the southern and western kings until we've adopted feudalism, which is going to take a while, because we've got to get up to maximum tribal organization, and we can only change laws once every 5 years. So, this character's probably not going to make it. I don't see him living another 20 years. Maybe if we get exceptionally lucky. They can. Characters can live that long. But we can do things like create the Duchy of Mordva and then grant that to our King of the North because he, as you'll notice, is a tribe guy. So we should be perfectly capable of granting him the High Chiefdom of Mordva. We'll click that button, even though it doesn't do anything, simply because it's force of habit. And we'll go on from there. So this guy, on the other hand, is part of another duchy, which we don't actually own, Chiremisa. But we're going to have this guy here. Mania, extend hugely north. Crimea, if I remember correctly. Well, that's interesting. Crimea. That would be you? Huh. Oh, is that the name of your dynasty? No. Did you just call it the High Chiefdom of Crimea? Yeah, okay. I'm just going crazy. It's fine. Don't worry about it. No problem. Take Bulgar. And we need to start conquesting some of these other little guys. But more importantly, we need to remember to pass laws every couple of years. So in October of 38 next year, we need to do that thing. Now, there's certain circumstances where you don't actually need to siege every province. But in pretty much all circumstances, I find it best to just siege the top holding anyway. Just to guarantee that you get all of the land. Alright, let's go ahead and offer peace to you. Force demands, sounds good. Okay. Just checking to see if we've got any subholdings. Looks like there's not very many. Alright, this is all land that's going to go to our King of the North. Let's go ahead and create the... No, not that duchy. This duchy over here. I don't want any of this land. This land is not for me. We'll just create the duchies. Create the duchies. And this one we don't actually have enough of the territory for. That's fine. We'll find our king. Khan Temugi of Kumania. And you can have the High Chiefdom of Bulgar. You can also have the High Chiefdom of Chiremisa. Now, I did create that Duchy of Fars when I was doing my example, and I forgot to do something with it, but I don't want to give it away until we create the kingdom down here on the off chance that it causes issues. But, if I think about it for a second, we could just make Persia the primary kingdom down here, because I didn't create Kiva, did I? No. We currently own Khanate of Wallachia, which we can't get rid of. We haven't created Persia. Okay, we can give away the duchy. We'll make Persia the southern king. That'll be fine. Now, also, people always say, they always do this. Every time I play the Crusader Kings 2, people are like, oh, be careful. You should only have content vassals. Right? That's not true. I'm not worried about it. In fact, here, I'm going to make this guy our guy. He's ambitious. We'll give him the duchy. And guess what? It doesn't matter. He's going to like us. And he's going to like our son, and it won't be a problem. Just you wait. See, the thing about ambitious vassals is that they only get upset when you have the wrong type of feudal layout. Like, if you have dukes and kings and things that don't own land that they shouldn't, then that's where you'll have problems. But because I very cautiously give territory away, usually, we don't ever have that problem. Unfortunately, my darn tribal vassals are not standing down because of this rebellion. What we could do, just to make this quicker, is if he's willing to accept white peace, just white peace him. Either way, he's imprisoned. We just get more prestige. So if we win one more battle, we might be able to just end this war a bit early. Two children like a guardian, our six-year-old. Cool. Let's educate him ourselves. Assuming we have a slot, we do. Okay, and then my daughter, we'll use her for opinion with anybody that's got power that doesn't like us. Be that guy. Don't care about her education at all. We have a daughter. Cool. a lot of kids. So if you notice my little thing, you should say something about it. You should mention it in the comments. But you're already my concubine. You don't necessarily need to be special interests anymore. And then you, I can't really kill your husband. No one seems to want to kill him. So we're just going to unspec you as special interest then. We'll check for strongs and geniuses again later. I don't care about that. Now, I am very curious to try out the duel. I want to duel people. But probably not with Genghis Khan. Oh, we've lost the siege. Alright, we're leading combat because we're awesome. We're the best. We're super awesome. Wow. Alright, so 35. Allow the duel. Go ahead. Have fun. Since we're here, might as well assault this. You're not going anywhere. We're at 78%. Can we just, can we get a white piece? Cool. Let's just do that. It's faster. Alright, finally, our vassals have stood down. So I'm assuming we're allowed to declare the next war. Invasion of Perm. Okay, so how many wars do we actually want to declare right now? Okay, make sure we pass this thing. This is in October 15th. 1238, still a year away. We can pass that while we're at war, no problem. Alright, so we'll just declare a bunch of wars. The invasion of Perm sounds good. How about we do... you should really be able to right-click on a country. Invasion of Ruthenia. The invasion of Ruthenia. I'm going to old-fashioned... whatever you call it. The way that I used to play... 10 wars at a time, at least. Apparently I failed to actually declare on you. Invasion... because the invasion is the best. Bring you all into the fold, and for good measure, we'll get you two. That's probably not too many wars, right? It's not that many, not really. Okay, so... it's a Mongolian invasion! Firm. I noticed it over here in the previous video. All my armies... it's a Mongolian army! I know it's Mongolian. I spelled it with an R on purpose. Because I have a funny sense of humor. And it's funny. Okay? So Mongols. Mongolians. Alright. Call all the things. Raise all the troops. Sounds great. Rally all the things. All the Mongolians. Let's go. Okay. Everyone go that way. Everyone. Okay, except for you, go there. And, let's see, so... Kumania, where did your army actually get raised? I'm assuming... Oh, you know what, you're a tribe. You probably have to answer the call. You're not gonna just show up for me, are ya? Alright, so we'll combine and then split, and we'll have half of you go to each of these two provinces. We'll have... we have pretty sizable troops up in this direction. So if you guys all go up that way, you'll take care of the north. And everyone else, yeah, do rally this way. Let's have you guys meet up, say, here. You meet up there. And let's play on, like, speed 3-ish for a little bit. So, yeah, we've declared the, it's a Mongolian invasion of Perm. It's a Mongolian invasion of Ruthenia. It's the second, it's a Mongolian, etc. And, it's a Mongolian invasion. The Mongols, they're... I'm sorry, guys. I'm gonna stop. Alright. So what do we got going? Are we sieging yet? There's 2,900 there. It's kind of sizable. I guess we can do speed 4. Alright, you are sizable. How about you guys, well, we kind of need you over here, actually. Let's grab a leader. Have you go down there. And let's have you guys form up that way. That's 4,200. We took all these guys, that's 66. Let's grab a couple more. About 9,000 would be nice. And, yeah, let's actually rally them, like, that way. Assuming 9,000 can go there. Yes, they can. Good. So altogether, we've got apparently 45,000 troops. Assuming that thing can be trusted, which it can't. Yes, it can. I just don't like how it's not always accurate. Sometimes it's not. I know I've seen it before where it's not accurate. But because we are a reformed Tengri, or whatever we are, we do have the vassal levies raised to long penalty, which does build up, which is kind of annoying. Hey, they're going to come engage us. Okay, well, we probably have too few men here. Ugh. Still, we're going to win because we're amazing. Yes, cool, 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 cool. They actually gave me a day, which means that I can appoint some leaders, crying out loud. At least give us a chance. And this army, I think I just unappointed a guy. There we go. Hey, go. Go, Mr. Mongolians. We'll take half of those men there, since that doesn't have enough. And, looking okay. These two armies together should be fine against whatever they put together. Our concubine is, pregnant. Ransom prisoners whenever I remember. Banish, sure. Our daughter-in-law has died. Okay. Now that is not an army that I'd really like to fight. 27th. 11th. Alright, you're going to be there by the 11th. Do you have organizings? Could we get an organizer? I cannot do it. Okay, well, try. I mean, try to run. Whatever. If we lose some, many Mongolians are going to die. That is true. It's just a fact. Part of the process of warring many people is that Mongolians will die. Yep. Battle of Semender we just lost. Somebody just got pregnant. Oh, right. Yeah, we totally declared a war on this guy. Is that where we lost the battle? Oops. Yeah, they've got a lot of men. Being a little bit sloppy, I'll admit. All right. See if we can rally up a sizable force there. Just disband you guys as soon as you get back to friendly territory. Since clearly you're not doing well. I may have declared war on too many people. It's possible. But that's part of the fun of it. Is declare more wars than you really have any right to and then see if you can win them. Oh no, we're dead! No! It's not good, we're dead. We didn't even have a chance to make... Alright, so basically... Genghis Khan had declared so many wars and then he actually lost a few battles and he was like, oh god, I need to die. So we're 7. That's cool. So be it. Check out our state of affairs. Our lowest opinion vassal is at -100 because he thinks we're heretic. We didn't even get to pass that law with our previous character. It's unfortunate. We've got wrong government type. With a bunch of people because they are feudal and we are still a tribal leader technically. We've got the large feudal tax, and then we have short reign penalty, and also we don't have a spouse, which is unfortunate. We've got a pretty good chancellor. Most of our characters are decent enough. Nothing to really change here. Alright, we are 8 out of 6, but we're going to get a regent. We already have a regent. We just need to get rid of some territory, make sure that nothing bad happens. Have some personally held territory up here. That'll be the easiest to get rid of. So let's do that. Okay, not grant landed title. Search for men who are not in prison. Why can't we grant title to you? Oh, we want to search in our court. Do-do-do-do. What's going on? Married. Oh, you know what it might be? Search for, search the realm, for men who are not in prison, who are any marriage, not currently a ruler, my culture, my religion. Don't tell me I'm like the wrong religion or something. I'm Tengri reformed. Yes, an adult, not a great house. And for some reason I can't grant landed titles. Needs to be approved by your regent. Ah, okay, now we know what's going on with some of this. Our region doesn't like us. That is really irritating. Hey, do you want some money? 120, fine. Here, I'll even make you that guy. How's that sound? Can I do what I want now? Am I allowed to grant landed titles? Jeez. kind of a silly arbitrary restriction. All right, so you can have this thing up here, and you can have that guy. That puts us at 6 out of 6. We still have too many vassals. These should belong to this guy, but we need to create that duchy before we can get rid of him. So I think what we do is we just find a few of our counts, preferably actually the ones that dislike us the most, and we get rid of them. So, like you, for instance, who belong up here, aren't you part of Kumania? You are. So we'll just get rid of this whole duchy. This will also have the added benefit of giving us some prestige. So we just created that duchy. We will now grant it to our king of the north. Very important that we make sure he likes us. He's a negative 25. Mostly because he desires the duchy I just created, which we'll give him. That also has the added benefit of lowering our vassal limit and also making this guy like us by quite a bit. At least he will. Granted a duchy plus 60. And we have no money, which is unfortunate. I also need to pick an educator for us. Educate child. We will choose a military man, I suppose. My nephew, who is 21. It's my nephew. Organizer. Content shy. No. We have a lunatic here. It's cool. It's gregarious. So what I'm looking for, what I prioritize, I want a level 4 educator. If at all possible. Just because I'll probably forget and leave him as my educator until I'm 16. But then also we want to pick somebody who's preferably got a bunch of virtues, doesn't have nasty things like arbitrary. Just because it'll impact the decisions that they make about us. Lunatic. I don't know that I've ever been educated by a lunatic, so I don't know if I want to do that. A great eminence wouldn't be terrible either. Actually, you know what? Now that we're in the vassal management stage of the game, a great eminence would probably be superior. So how about we choose... See, you're arbitrary. Honest, paranoid, cynical, shy. You'll do fine. You'll do fine, Mom. Teach me the ways, diplomatic ways. Mommy will take care of me. She's never going to want to murder me. That'd be crazy. All right, you're landed, so we'll want to improve relations with you, primarily. Train troops couldn't hurt. And we need to win as many of these wars as we can, as quickly as we can, so that we get some prestige, so that people like us. That's important. So, negative 100. Heretic zealous, heretic zealous. Okay, check factions, see how those are looking. We have an independence faction with 66% of our strength right now. That's interesting. Let's call other people to war. Now, if they were built against us while we're in this midst of all this stuff, that would be pretty unfortunate. Okay, you are here. Peaceful Mongols. We need money. Okay, well, I'm going to take a break here. Next video, we will set things straight. So, thanks for watching, everyone. See you soon.